I remember the wonder of being a child, when food was always exciting.
But as we get older, that excitement often disappears.
I want to bring back the wonder of food on a monumental scale to remind us of just how magical food can be.
Creating a titanic tea break.
Turning ice cream into a record-breaking event.
The largest cone in the world.
And breakfast into an epic journey. I built my reputation on combining food and science on a micro scale. So putting down the tweezers and stepping into the land of the giants is, for me, a journey into the unknown. But it's worth the risk to bring back that magic to us all.
This time, I'm putting the fun back into a food and drink tradition that's fading fast. Oh. The Great British Boozer.
Who's up for some pie? Yes.
To make an edible pub, I'll be building with pastry. Oh. Making monsters come to life.
Now that is what I call a pork scratching.
And building a giant pie, then turning it into the most incredible pub ever.
I never want to leave this pub. This is fabulous.
This is my record-breaking, fantastical food adventure, and everyone is invited.
There's nothing we Brits love more than a good old-fashioned pie and pint. For centuries, our British boozers have been a wondrous mix of good times, hearty grub, and beer that's made us famous the world over.
So you join us for a pint of bitter at what many call the Englishman's second home, his pub.
The pub is one of Britain's greatest inventions. It's a place that brings communities together to catch up over a pint. And even before I was old enough to drink beer, I love bar snacks.
In fact, I love them so much I came up with my own Scotch egg with a twist. It's a quail's egg with a rich, runny yolk inside. But the traditional British boozer is disappearing fast. In the last 7 years, an incredible 8,000 local pubs have shut down.
Pubs just like these up and down the country are closing. It would be a disaster if we lost one of the most wonderful things about our heritage. I mean, just imagine Britain without the local boozer. So I want to do something truly unique. For one day, I want to build the most incredible pub ever and make us realise just how special these places are.
Right now, I've got no idea how I'm going to create my pub. But first things first, I need to find a place to do it.
I've read about this village in North Wales. They've lost their community pub and it's been such a massive dent to their village life that they're campaigning to bring it back. So I'm on my way there to meet them and find out more.
Once a bustling pub in the heart of the village, the Tinny Capel called its very last orders in February 2011. Villagers are so desperate to get their boozer back, one of the locals has created his own temporary pub in his garden shed.
Yakida!
It may not be the Queen Vic, but for regulars Vicky, Larry and landlord Brian, it is the next best thing.
Is this officially the smallest pub in Britain?
Hi, Hestons.
So, okay? How are you doing?
Yeah, fine. Nice to see you. Welcome to the shed. What can I get you?
I should have a beer, a bitter. So, do you have last orders? Do you open at a certain time?
No.
So, lock-ins it is, then. Cheers. So, tell me about your pub that's no longer.
Yeah, well, Tinny Capel, sadly. It's always been a very, very friendly place. Anybody new moving into the village, anything we want to know about anybody.
I mean, what do you think, what did that pub do for the village?
It was the hub of the community, I would say. But it's just not just my area, you know, it's happening everywhere.
Listening to the locals talk about their old pub, it's obvious just how much they miss it.
If it did, you know, get to open again, then everybody from around there could all get back together again.
Yeah.
You know, you get to know people then better, yeah. and everyone gets to know each other, you know. You know what I mean, don't you?
Yeah. We used to have good quizzes and things like
quiz
that.
Quiz nights and, you know, clothes.
It'd be great if the pub was back open again. It really would.
That has to be one of the most bizarre pubs I've ever been in. It's Garden Shed. But you know what? If you brush that aside, it's all about the people.
Having met the villagers here, I'm convinced that this is the perfect place to create a truly unique boozer. And my pub will, of course, need some very special grub. Whether it's a traditional meat pie or bangers and mash, our public houses have always championed classic British food. And it's also responsible for some real surprises. The Ploughman's Lunch was a pub meal dreamt up in the 60s to get us all to eat more cheese. I'd like my pub to serve the very best iconic British dishes. To find the nation's top choice, I'm hitting the streets. So, what is Britain's favourite pub grub? On the Occhi, a selection of our most loved pub dishes, from old school bangers and mash to the traditional meat pie.
One last pub grub supper, what would it be?
Yeah, good old meat pie.
But you've got one dart. Oh! Good pie.
Yes, definitely sausage and mash.
A beef and ale pie.
The nation has spoken.
It's just got to be the pie.
Now I've got some ideas for the grub and found the perfect village location, I'm off to my secret lab. And I won't be coming out until I've come up with a plan for a truly fantastical public house. I can't have a pub without some pork scratchings, so how about I make mine supersize? I could serve up my own tasty take on pub games by making them edible. No self-respecting pub would be complete without its own beer, brewed in secret with some magical ingredients. And we love a pie with our pint, so what if I could make mine mind-blowingly big, then put the boozer inside it? The world's first pub in a pie!
Right, that's the plan. Looks easy.
Coming up... construction starts on my pub in a pie. For me, there's always been something special about the hub of every community. The great British boozer. But our pubs are disappearing at a rate of 18 every week, and I want to help find a way to stop this tragic loss with an idea so big and crazy we're just going to have to sit up and take notice. As a child, I remember being so enchanted by Hansel and Gretel. The idea of a whole house made of sweets was just incredible. So I want to create an adult version of an edible public house. I want to build a giant pie and turn it into the most amazing pub ever. I'm back in North Wales in the village of Manera, and it's time to break my crazy idea to the locals.
Morning all. So, people of Manera, I think it's time to make a stand and try and get this pub back to your village. My plan is to build the most magical pub for a day that will get people talking. It'll get them talking far and wide, get them here and realise what's happened. So I want to build, with your help, a pie. I want to build a pie large enough to house a pub inside it. Now, if that doesn't get people talking, I don't know what will. But I can't do it alone, so I need all your help. I need a landlord. So, Brian, will you be my landlord?
I'll be honoured.
Fantastic. Now, I need the barmaid with the mostess.
Vicky!
So, Vicky, will you be my barmaid?
I would be delighted, Heston.
I think, finally, what I need is that local that's going to be there. Come rain, snow, propping up the bar. It's got to be Larry. Yeah. Okay, so we've got a team. All we need to do now is build a pub out of pies. Are you up for it?
Yes! Yes.
Oh, it's absolutely phenomenal. Just can't believe it's happening. Pie in a pint? Brilliant idea.
As long as you don't have to eat our way in, it's all right.
I mean, it's absolutely absurd. I mean, how on earth is he going to bake a pie big enough? And to keep it standing? How is it going to stay there?
Here's to our new pub.
Cheers.
Cheers!
There's no going back now. I might not have a pub yet, but I've got my team. And one thing's for sure, every good local needs a good beer. We Brits just love a pint of bitter. Beer making's in our blood. For centuries we've been brewing beer and coming up with some novel ways to drink it.
Only the bravest visitors have a go at the traditional yard of ale. You can laugh, but although the glass holds only 2 pints, it's more tricky than you'd think.
I don't even know where you start. Number one.
For my pub in a pie, I need a beer that will be a real talking point, a unique brew made by the locals themselves and me.
Easy step-by-step guide to making your own pop-up brewery.
So we've set up a makeshift brewery in Brian's garage.
Plus viscosity and other body forces.
Easy. Let's get it started.
It turns out making great beer is really quite complicated. So we've got brewing experts Gwyn Thomas and Rupert Ponsonby to show us what to do. We'll need malted barley, hops for the classic bitter flavour, and our first task is to choose the mix of malts for our unique village beer.
We need to eat some malt, work out what brew we want to make, and this is the Monera brew.
That's nice.
It always tastes slightly honeyed, very nice, very easy, very creamy.
I like that one.
I feel like a guinea pig, eating all this.
The malted grain is mixed with hot water to make a mash.
This is pouring in the first part of our Monera blend.
Should start to get some really nice malt aromas coming out now.
Wow.
That's really nice.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, smell that. The heart of this whole thing, it has to be the Monera beer. So this stage is really important. It's exciting.
It really is, yeah.
What does she smell like?
It smells great. Yeah.
When you said we were going to be brewing, I didn't think we were going to be so hands-on. I was, you know, choosing the malt and the hops, obviously, and actually brewing it ourselves. Yeah, it's fantastic, yeah.
None of us know how it's going to taste or how it's going to end, you know, but yeah, it's pretty exciting. And Heston being here as well, you know. It's
great. It smells like proper beer.
News of our beer brewing has travelled fast and a rather special visitor has just popped into the garage.
We must be doing something pretty good here today because the local priest just arrived. He's been sniffing around the brew. He must have smelt it from higher above.
Graham, nice to meet you. How are you? Could you smell the
yes, I can smell beer. Yes, I can.
Are you a beer man?
Mom?
Are you a beer man?
Well, not a lot, but I do that. Right. I have been.
Yeah. Could you bless it?
What, yes. The beer? Well, yeah. It'd be better then, will it?
Bless, O Lord, this mixture, that it may be for the betterment of all who will drink it. May they be kept alive and well forever. Amen.
Well, I think strange things happen in Monera. Can't believe it. Vic has just turned up. And he's blessed the beer.
All we can do now is just pray that our fledgling brew ferments into a champion beer. However it turns out, a pint should always be served with a bar snack.
One of the great things about bar snacks is just, it's the sheer choice of them. So what I want to do is turn each of these bar snacks into a beer head, so everyone can choose their own beer foam topping. First off, one of my absolute favourites, Frazzles.
I'm combining an infusion of smoked bacon and syrup with egg whites, and then soaking Frazzles in water.
Okay, then add that to the mixture. All right, now just give it a good old mix.
This may look disgusting, but trust me, I'm a chef.
So what I need to do now is foam it.
To do that, I'm using a nitrous oxide whipped cream siphon.
Right, so here's my beer. If I carefully just dispense. So there we have my smoky bacon flavoured beer head. Cheers.
And my bar snacks don't end there.
There's nothing that says pub more than one of these. Pork scratching. This is just not big enough for my pie pub. However, this will be. All you need to do is take 2 gallons of oil, get it really hot, and then drop in half the belly of a pig.
I've steamed the skin in a vacuum bag so that when it cooks, it'll blow up just like a balloon.
It does look brilliant. It's outrageous. I know this might look like something from outer space, but in fact, it's one incredibly large pork scratching.
I have to say, that's worked out really rather well.
Now that is what I call a pork scratching. So you can see it's incredibly light. It's got these little bubbles, air pockets, and very crispy.
It's time to start work on the main course, my monster pie. Making a pub inside a pie is uncharted territory, so I first want to try building a model version of the pie's arched roof.
The plan is to layer the sheets, my pastry tiles, up like this, which I might bind with some mashed potato. Then I need to put a keystone at the top and then tiles down the other side. Theory, if we get it right, we'll be able to remove this wooden mould and we'll have a perfect arch. And that could form an edible roof for my pie pub.
For this much dough, it's a 4-man job, so I've roped in my design squad, John, Julian and Giles.
Start mixing.
As this is a trial run, to minimise the waste, I'm using basic pastry ingredients for the tiles and leftover potatoes to stick them together.
Right, 104 tiles, it's time to make an arch. I know what we're eating for dinner.
The Roman arch is one of the wonders of architecture. Normally, bricks and mortar held together by the sheer force of slab pressed against slab.
1, 2, 3. Okay, whoa. Now we've got to remove the wooden support and see if this thing stands up. Right then, chaps, let's do it.
In theory, this pastry arch should support itself.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Here we are.
Stop, Smithy, stop.
Whoa. Whoa.
What were we thinking?
As this has hit the floor, it's now more pig fodder than pub grub. So next time, I've got to get this right. What I need is some expert help. So I'm consulting with structural engineers Steve McKechnie and Stephen Thompson. These guys are from the firm that built the gherkin, so I'm guessing making edible landmarks should be right up their street. So I thought, why not build a pub out of pies?
Build a pub out of pies?
Yeah.
Right.
And I thought you might be the expert to tell me to do this.
Pub out of pies.
Because, you know, bricks and pies, metal and pies, the same kind of thing, isn't it?
So, what do we think this might look like?
It could look like a pub. It could look like a giant pie.
So you could make a wall like a pork pie or something, and you'll put them one on top of each other like that.
Exactly. But is it actually possible to build a wall out of pies?
Yeah. If we used that as a brick.
Hang on.
That's just touching on one point on the top there.
Need some mortar first. Fanning skills.
I hope this actually makes it better. It spreads the load nicely into the top of the pastry. The pastry lower down is showing a little bit of.
Oh, let's go bold.
I may have to provide a little bit of lateral restraint here.
Yeah, go for it. Oh.
In fact, the mashed potato works fairly well.
Do you know what? I think there's my.
That's artistic.
I'm off on holiday now. I've done my work. With my head buzzing with ideas, I'm going back to the drawing board in my secret lab. Would it be possible to build a wall of pie bricks? I could make really strong brick-shaped pastry cases, then fill them with my own take on some classic pub grub dishes. And if I can do that, I might just have the makings of an edible pub. Coming up, the success of my monster pie hangs in the balance. The weather's like this. I don't know what's hanging out onto my roof. People are going to turn up and see a soggy pie. I want to put the fun back into a disappearing landmark, the Great British Boozer, with a plan to make a giant pie and turn it into the most amazing pub ever. Are you up for it?
Yes!
This is where I plan to build my pub in a pie, Manera, an old mining village in North Wales. Right, this is it. This is the spot. This is Manera Park. The pub, the old pub, you can just see the roof there. The church is over there. This makes perfect sense. See, I've got to get this right because this is all about raising awareness to kick momentum off so eventually these guys can have their beloved pub, the centre of the heart of the community, back here again. Vital to the pub's success is our Manera brew. It's halfway through fermentation and in theory on its way to tasting like great beer. Hi, Brian.
Oh, hi, Aston. How are you?
Yeah, I'm good, thanks.
You okay today?
Yeah, I thought I'd just come and have a look at the beer.
Yeah, certainly, come in.
Thanks. Yeah. Our fledgling beer has found the ideal place to ferment. Tucked amongst the shirts and socks in Brian's airing cupboard. It's all right, actually. It's not beer-like enough yet, but it's certainly hoppy and there's a nice sweetness, a bit of bitterness, a bit of acidity. It'll be weeks before we find out whether the Manera beer has worked just the way I want it. In the meantime, I want to get to grips with my giant pie. I've decided to try and build it with pie bricks. The big question is how to make them. I need some serious help. I've come to Yorkshire to see some experts in pie making.
This man has dedicated his life to making pies. Andrew Jones has spent 25 years honing his recipes and reckons he's made more than 15 million. But what will you make of my plan to build the mother of all pies?
I need to make a giant pie large enough to house a pub that people can go into. Oh, a working
good.
Pub.
Oh, that's good, sir.
So obviously, I'm not expecting you to come up with one giant pie.
No.
What I am asking, what I am hoping, is you can produce enough pies of the right shape that I can use for building material.
Okay.
Like roof tiles, I need bricks. What do you think?
You come up with some wacky stuff, don't you? Well, I mean, how's it going to work, that? I mean, what happens if it rains for a start, you know?
No, I haven't got that far yet.
All right,
obviously,
okay.
I can deal with that. I'll think about that.
Right, yeah,
I'm hoping to persuade Andrew to help make the pastry cases for my pie bricks.
This pastry,
great, isn't it? Yeah, crisp.
It's crisp and it's tough.
Yeah.
And so it's got a really nice strength to it. It's no good me making a really nice, soft, delicate pie because the whole thing's going to collapse. Obviously, they're the wrong shape.
Yeah. All sorts of. Minute. I've got some of those. Do you think we could do something with that?
Yeah, they can work.
Yes, that way. Yeah, looks a bit like a wall.
We're in business. Andrew's up for it, albeit with a few reservations.
He's asked me some wacky thing that he wants to make a pub out of pies or a pie-shaped pub or whatever it is. I still can't get my head around it. The idea, in principle, is fantastic, but will they pull it off? I think it's absolutely bonkers.
Manera Village Park. For the past 4 days, strange things have been happening inside a giant canvas tent.
Oh, there's something really weird going on under that marquee. They've been banging and they've been making all sorts of noises all around, and we know that there's something a bit crazy going on in there.
It's certainly out of the ordinary, isn't it?
The building of my giant pie has finally begun. Although much of the pie will be pastry, bricks and tiles that people can eat, health and safety don't quite share my confidence. So they've said I need some wooden structural supports and polystyrene edging on the roof. Overseeing this gargantuan task is my chief engineer, David.
And this has always been the one that everyone's sort of secretly hoped we would go away. I think it might be the most ridiculous thing we've ever done.
And that's not all. Looming on the horizon is an obstacle that's beyond their control.
Just been really unlucky with the weather. Originally it was going to be heat wave, and then it was forecast for snow. And in fact, it hasn't done either of those things. It's just pissed down all the time. I mean, this is North Wales, basically. This is pretty much the worst place to do this in the whole of the British Isles.
While David and the team battle with the build, I've returned to my secret lab. I want my pie brick fillings to be a real surprise.
My pub might be made of pie, but I still want to incorporate some of the classic pub grub dishes into it, like this, the ploughman's. So my idea is to turn this into a very special pie filling.
I'm using braised ham hock mixed with a piccalilli jelly, which I'm layering into a classic tureen, along with a line of pickled cauliflower.
And another layer of the piccalilli ham mix. And now a row of cheddar cheese, the heart of any ploughman's.
On top of that, I'm layering pickled spiced shallots and a row of tomatoes.
Okay, a ploughman's would not be complete without a touch of celery, gherkin, and apple. So that's going to be my last layer. And then just a final coating of ham hock.
Next, I seal it with cling film, weight it down, and after a few hours in the fridge, it's set.
I'll just slice through here. You should be able to see cheddar, cauliflower, pickled shallot, tomato, and the bottom row, we've got apple, gherkin, and celery. So, one tureen and one super strong pastry case. And I'll have the ultimate pub pie brick. It's the day before the grand opening of my pub in a pie. My pie bricks filled with pub grub are now made, so it's time to start building the walls. Thing is, we've got an awful lot of these pie bricks, but looking at the area we need to cover, I really don't know if we've got enough. Keen to do their bit for the new pub.
Hi guys, how are you doing?
The villagers have rushed to my aid.
Are they bricks?
Yes.
Oh, brilliant. Have you all got them?
Yeah.
Fantastic. Stack them up.
He's got strong arms.
The reinforcements can make all the difference, even if the locals aren't quite sure what's going on inside the tent.
Well, he's building a pub in a...
Is it a pub in a pie?
Or a pie in
I don't know whether the pie...
That's all we need.
Is the pie going to be very large?
It certainly will be if we can get it finished. But we're missing a key ingredient of the classic boozer, and that's some traditional pub games. And for me, the undisputed king of them all has got to be the fruit machine. So with the help of my design guru, Giles, I'm going to adapt one to pay out in bar snacks.
Let's open her up.
OK, and where do we get in?
Oh, there you go.
Well, you just did that pretty quickly. A good old shake.
I think going that way might help.
Ow! Here's the reason why I shouldn't have done that. OK, so here I've got a packet of Brazil nuts.
Bingo.
My nuts are loaded and we're good to go.
Fantastic feature, too many choices.
Oh my God, how did that happen?
Fruit machine sorted. Next, I've got a plan to give my punters the shock of their lives. With an edible billiard table. First off, you need a table. This is my table. For the base, I've layered cod with tartar sauce, topped with a pea mousse. Doesn't exactly look like the bays of a billiard or snooker table yet. It will in a second. This is going to be a bit noisy and just a little bit messy. For the classic green table, I'm spraying a mix of cocoa butter, watercress, and some crumbled up crisps. Now I need to add one of the key elements of bar billiards, the little wooden skittles that are shaped like mushrooms. If you knock them over, you lose points. So I'm making my skittles with a brioche that I've made with a mushroom puree. Okay, so you can't play bar snack billiards without some balls. My balls are hard-boiled pickled eggs, and with a bit of kitchen magic, by rubbing them between the palms of my hands, I've turned them into perfectly round spheres. And the red ball is a Scotch egg coated in red pepper and cardamom jelly.
So for those of you watching in black and white, the red ball is behind the Scotch egg.
Tell you what, bar billiard balls never used to taste like this.
There's one final job before I open the door of my pub in a pie, and that's to tap the villagers' own Manera brew.
You have to give it a good old whack.
Watch his fingers.
No, right?
Hit it hard.
You ready? You ready?
Yeah,
go. Oh my God. Please.
Don't hit my hand.
Right?
Oh, go. And go, go, go. But nicely done. Well, tap's on.
He's tapped it.
Yeah, that's it. He's done it. Try and get a turn.
Beer tapped. It's finally time to see how it tastes. It's really good.
Right, close the door.
It's a locking.
It's a locking. We're going to have a locking before
that's
it's even
really
unlocked.
That's really good.
Yeah. No, that's fine.
The beta going.
A giant pie pub opens tomorrow. It's been a long, mad, exhausting adventure. I just pray we can pull it off. In there is something so ambitious. It's pushed myself, my team, to the absolute limit. Tomorrow that's going to be unveiled. The weather's like this. I don't know what's going to happen to my roof. People are going to turn up and see a soggy pie. Coming up, D-Day for my craziest, most ambitious plan ever.
Inside this pie is your new pub.
Our beloved British pubs are disappearing fast. And I've been on an epic quest to put the fun back into the food and drink of the British boozer. Early morning in the Welsh village of Manera. After weeks of toil, the big day has finally arrived.
Things have been happening here. There's been forklift trucks, there's been tractors, there's been people turning up with bits and pieces. It's still a mystery.
I've heard of this famous chef coming, but I haven't heard what he's doing. Something about pies or something, I don't know, I haven't heard really much.
Hoping to draw in the punters from far and wide, I've spread some special invitations around the village.
Hestons Golden Beer Mat. Greetings to you, the lucky holder of this golden beer mat from Heston Blumenthal. Present this ticket at the Heston Arms in Manera Park at 1 p.m.
In your wildest dreams, you cannot imagine the pub that awaits you. It's something you don't expect in Manera. It's got like the Willy Wonka feel to it, isn't it? So the golden ticket and stuff like that. So it's all a bit of a mystery, isn't it?
Countdown's begun. My magical pub in a pie is finally ready. Welcome to my pub. I'm keeping the pie exterior secret for now. Come and have a look inside. This is a public house like no other, with edible walls made from pie bricks, a billiard table of cod, pea mousse and brioche mushrooms, a fruit machine with a savoury payout, a unique beer brewed by the locals for the locals, and the strangest way ever to eat a bar snack. Now here are my special beer head foams. I've got peanut, sausage roll, frazzles, and finally, classic scampi fries. And this way, you can tailor your beer to your very favourite bar snack. If that wasn't enough to blow the punters away, I've got the world's first edible optics made from whiskey, rum, and brandy jellies. And of course, my monster from the deep fat fryer, my supersized pork scratchings. My giant pub in a pie is ready to unveil. Word has spread down the village and beyond.
I've heard rumours that there might be a pie under there.
But you never know what he's going to do.
Yeah, yeah.
That's what makes it interesting.
There is a big sense of anticipation. This whole giant pie is shrouded in mystery. Just seeing the villagers, and I'm not sure just how big their expectations are, but they're pretty big. Hello, Manera! Up and down the country, the local boozer, the village pub, is disappearing. So what I wanted to do was create something quite special and magical right here for one day in Manera.
And it doesn't stop there. Inside this pie is your new pub.
Finally, my boozer and a pie is open for business.
It's amazing.
Yeah.
This is unbelievable. Unbelievable.
So I now officially declare the Manera Pub in a Pie open.
For one day only, the Heston Arms aims to put the fun and the magic back into the village pub.
Would you like to taste the table?
Yeah.
Right there, go right to the bottom, is it?
I've never eaten a table before.
Oh, dinner, dig in.
Wow, that's lovely.
Beats chalking up, didn't
it?
Billiard table demolished. Now for the main course. A large helping of pub wall.
Okay, so who's up for some pie? Yes.
My pie bricks are filled with pub grub classics. Bangers and mash, prawn cocktail, and of course, the ploughman's.
I'm going to actually eat the wall of a pub, and that is great.
Welcome to the pub.
So far, so good. The grub's going down a treat. They're even eating the beer mats. Well, they are edible.
Hansel and Gretel's house. Eat away at everything.
That's really good. There's a drop of scotch in it, isn't it?
This, yes, that was made up.
Mm. You're rather nice.
Yeah.
Hello.
I never want to leave this pub. This is fabulous. Everyone's in such a good mood and really good spirits, and they're all loving the beer. I love it.
After weeks of waiting, it's a massive relief to see our very own beer hitting the spot.
I can smell the frazzles on it.
Cheers.
It's scratching. Okay, just break them up and pass them around.
It's always been a ludicrously ambitious plan, but it's working beyond my wildest dreams.
The sense of community spirit here is just amazing, and like, just the fact it's a pie as well, it's incredible.
Very exciting. Most exciting thing that's happened in the village ever, I think.
We're almost ready to call time on the world's first pub inside a giant pie.
What an experience, something completely different to anything you'd normally do. To eat a pool table, to eat the walls, you know, it's not normal, and got sausage roll beer here, so great, really different.
Alice in Wonderland stuff, yeah.
Heston can do anything really, can't he? You know, I didn't think it was going to be like as good as this, I really didn't, but I mean, this is just, it's amazing.
This has been a huge challenge. But I've tried to put the fun back into the food and drink of the great British boozer to make us think twice before we turn our backs on a place that's given us all so much.
The pub is such a unique and magical element of our heritage. It's not just somewhere that serves beer. It's somewhere that brings people together.
And that's something worth keeping, something very special.
been a great day. Great day for the village, and, you know, bringing a pub back to the village as well. Fantastic.
What we really, really need in every village is somewhere for people to go, to get together, to have that community. You know, the older people to mix with the younger community. You know, that's really what the pubs should all be about.
The thing was, within 5 minutes you felt at home. You know, and I think everybody's reaction is the same, you know. It's unbelievable.
Next time, I'm taking on the childhood packed lunch. Going back to school, I had my first snog in there, building giant chocolate bars.
Oh, it's a really big crack in it.
And attempting to make a record-breaking crisp.
Big enough that you can hula in.
All in a bid to bring back the excitement of the lunchbox.
Oh, wow, a grown-up packed lunch. This is nice.
If you've missed any other instances of Heston getting food and making it really big, catch up with the whole series on 4OD right now. My favourite's the one with all the sweets. Right, big gritty drama next, and all this week too, the beating heart of Brighton's criminal underworld catch the fear in a minute.